All right, guys, so today we're going to be talking about the Flying Rogue specialization. Whenever you get one of the character classes to power level 20, you get to choose one of three specializations and fine-tune the character to really suit your playstyle and your needs on the battlefield. Allows you to differentiate your units from other people's units and really make your strategy your own. So by the time we are done with this video, you're going to understand all three specializations completely, understand which ones suit which playstyle, hopefully get you able to pick the one that works best for you, and also talk about the one that I'm going to be taking for myself as well. All right, guys, if you love the content that we're doing here, please support the channel by picking up some of the Vash Core skins. These are awesome red and black army skins. As you can see, we put a lot of work into them. We got our entire army there, and the newest one is the Meeks Rogue. The Meeks Rogue is something we're very proud of. Meeks loves her little rogue. So anyway, guys, pick one up, and it really helps us out to keep on making videos and keep doing what we're doing. So thank you so much. All right, let's get right into it. So the rogue specialization, this is the Flying Rogue, rogue assassin character. It is a nasty character, and we're going to talk about all three of its specialties. So the level 20 specialization gives you three options: the Armored Flying Rogue, the Focused Flying Rogue, or the Swift Flying Rogue. The Armored Flying Rogue is a specialized flying assassin unit that targets support enemies and takes 50% less ranged damage. So this one here is actually really, really nasty, because the whole purpose of the assassin class is to try to chase down and kill archers or support units. He will specifically go after support units before anything else, and they hit very, very hard. They are flying units, so they can cover any territory. They don't get hung up when they're flying over your own units or over enemy units. This does mean that you have to be kind of aware of your position, because you can easily fly over top of an enemy army trying to chase down support units that are lingering way in the back. But the advantage of this armored flying rogue is that when you put your position in the right spot and you kind of go around the outside and flank and go after the archers, you're going to end up getting targeted by the archers, and you don't have a lot of health, right? It's not a very strong unit, isn't it? It's an assassin unit, and putting the extra armor on it allows you to basically nullify the enemy attack against your character, because the flying enemies are only susceptible to ranged attacks and giant epic units. So seeing as how you're going to be going after their ranged units, and the ranged units are one of the only ones that can actually attack you, having super heavy armor versus those units can give you huge amounts of survivability and soak a lot of damage that you need to give yourself enough time to really wipe out a large amount of the enemy archer forces. So the Armored Flying Rogue is extremely, extremely dangerous. Now, the Focused Flying Rogue is a specialized flying assassin unit that targets and deals 200% extra damage to support enemies. So this one is just all about offense, right? Rather than taking a bunch of damage and reducing the damage that you take from attacks, this one is designed to just basically delete enemies as fast as you can. This kind of puts you, you know, at a bit of a disadvantage if you get targeted. Your 200% extra damage sounds like a lot, but it might be zero if you get killed before you get a shot off, right? So that's kind of the catch 22, is the 200% is amazing if you can position your hero in a way that you don't get hit. But if you make a mistake, the punishment is extreme, because that 200% damage all of a sudden becomes nothing, because you die before you get to them. Their archers have longer range than your flying rogues, so keep that in mind. They outrange you. So you need to get in and often soak some damage before you're able to actually get your attacks off. And if you die first, then you're toast, right? You're toast. So both of them are incredibly effective. Super, super awesome abilities. You can go for a flying tank assassin, or you can go with just the ultimate glass cannon, just hit like a truck assassin. Both are really, really good. The Swift Flying Rogue is a specialized flying assassin that targets support enemies and moves 50% faster. Now, this one here, this one is really, really neat, because having movement speed bonuses really opens up the game for you. Like, you can, especially when it comes to cleanup, the thing that I really enjoy doing with Swift characters, super, super mega fast characters, is putting them at the very, very furthest point from the battle. Because Swift can get you killed just as easily as it can help you. If you put your guy on the front line, your guy's just going to go charging straight in and die instantly. And you will do nothing and you will get nothing. However, if you put him at the very furthest point all the way back, then what will end up happening is your guy will take a little bit of time to catch up to the front line. But he moves very fast, right? So what will happen is the enemies will clash, and then your guy will all of a sudden just barrel over top of the enemies, and he moves so quick that he'll be able to close the distance between an archer and him. So even if their archer switches targets, your guy will already be on top of them and will be getting guaranteed damage. If you put your guy at the very back of the fight, you will guaranteed get effectiveness out of that character. And if you get lucky, having super speed allows you to go from target to target to target really, really fast, causing just descent and chaos throughout the enemy lines. It is super effective, super fun, and really, when it comes to the Flying Rogue, there is no wrong answer. Whether you want to be a tanky archer killer, or a one-shot archer killing machine, or a super, super fast, hunt archers down, just like jump, jump, jump from target to target to target, each of these three, classes are extremely effective and offer you different playstyles and different thoughts to think about when you're considering where to place the unit to get the optimal effect out of your flying rogues. So that is how they work. For me personally, when I'm using flying rogues, I really, really like damage. I like that super, super mega assassin. I like to do tons and tons of damage. I'm not too concerned with moving fast. I have a tendency to put my characters a ways back behind the front lines, so he takes a while to get up to catch up. And then by the time he does catch up, I kind of want to make sure that he one-shots, kills a lot of the enemy forces. But yeah, there's no right and wrong answer with this one. I actually love all of these builds, and regardless of what you take, you're going to be very, very happy. So, all right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you like and subscribe. Leave a thumbs up. It really helps the channel grow. Ring that bell for notifications. And yeah, comment down below. Let me know what video you'd like me to cover next. And yeah, thank you so much for being a part of the VashCore, guys. Thank you for watching these videos. Thank you for subscribing. Yeah, it means the world. I know this is not a big game, and it really means a lot that you guys are supporting, the VashCore. So thank you so much, guys, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Oh yeah.